As a choreographer, Christopher has done what all the avant-garde and experimental choreographers have done on stage in ballet and modern dance, which is that he took a basic language in skating and did something very creative with it. More specifically, he got away from the idea that you go from turn to leap. He's very concerned with linkage and transition. Continuing the dance in between the so-called elements, and the elements are completely incorporated into the fabric of whatever they're trying to say. And that's exactly what George Balanchine, who was certainly one of ballet's all-time greats, did now in the 20th century, which is to show that it isn't just steps, you have to put them together in sentences. Choreography can be very ordinary. What I think he did is exactly what somebody like Fred Astaire and his choreographers did, is that they went out into the field of entertainment without losing any sort of artistic integrity. One of their new kinds of pieces is Missing, which I think is actually a difficult piece, both for them and the audience. So I don't think the audience, at least in the States, always gets it.
About the music, or heard more of the music, I started reading bits in the paper, and obviously it was that period of the military oppression in South America, and at the same time the movie Missing was coming out, and this whole influence about the oppression there, and it stimulated a lot of ideas of what I said about taking in everything that's happening and wanting to present it in your way on the ice.
Do I love open first.
To back.
Back first, and to the...
We didn't really have access to having a full-time ballet teacher until we turned professional, and that was when we met up with Andris Toppe, who's still working with us. Having come across him later, we really appreciate what knowledge he has to give us, and we really enjoy taking a ballet class. I remember going to a ballet class as a child, sort of maybe about age 12, 13, and I giggled most of the time because I went with my friend because someone had told us if we were skating we should go to ballet, and we went. And I went through all the movements, but I didn't know why I was doing it. I didn't really want to. I did it just to say I'd been, and I know a lot of people do that now. Skaters go to say they've been. It's not until you're older that, and not until I was older that I really appreciated it. I wanted to know why, and took it all in and utilized that knowledge on the ice.
Skaters develop a style that they can do, and that's all they can do, that they're not adaptable to work with a choreographer who has an idea and works with a body and then sculpts it and shapes it to do his idea. We're not like the dance world, and that's where I see there's a big tragedy at the moment with skaters, that I'd like to see them have a universal way of being taught and then adapt their styles outside of that to have the versatility to do anything. There are so many good dance companies around the world. Ballet Rambert, New York City Ballet, ABT. It's like music. They all have something to offer. There's always something to see, and there's always something creative. I'm like a sponge at the moment because it's so new to me, even though I've been watching it for the last 8 or 9 years now, but it still feels so new and fresh.
Most music that I hear, you have a picture of skating to it or a movement to it in your head. You feel the rhythm of it somehow, I don't know. I mean, if I heard a heavy metal band, I wouldn't have a picture of skating to it in my head. But other music, even some modern music, you can visualize doing something to it. I like to really know the music that I'm skating to for timing and everything.
of Spanish dancing, they talk about duende, the soul, and I think the focus is definitely down into the ground and inward. You're supposed to float around in the ice, and they stamp on it, and they seem to be digging a hole into it, and of course that throws the audience off. And then you always have a sigh of relief, I think, when the music starts, because the audience feels more at home. I think that stretches the audience's experience. I don't think you should cater to the audience's preferences. I think you should lead the audience forward.
If we want to go and perform to a large audience, there is a certain format. The audience are coming to watch something that they've seen before. But what I'm saying is that it's mass appeal and in some ways safe. But where we're heading now in an experimental way would maybe alienate that audience, and that the people will come and see it and go, oh no, I don't like it. It's not what I expected. It's not Torvill and Dean. But there's another side of me that's saying that if it's there, you have to do it, regardless.
Look, turn, and one, and two, and three, and four, and one, and two, and three, and four, and turn, turn, arabesque, down, one, two. Better, Paul. Bong, tooth, and yeah. Da, da, da. One, two, three.
I don't have enough room. Yeah. Sorry. Da,
da, da. At the beginning, it's a little bit of a nightmare because you have to try and handle all these difficult positions, which are not all natural on the first day. But it's really encouraging after several weeks when it starts developing, and all these positions that you never thought you could do start gelling together, and then it really gets interesting. But the first few weeks, it's hard. It's really hard. You must not get discouraged, and you have to fight through.
Come on, push me. Watch.
Okay.
He likes to have his idea not tampered with, you know, like he doesn't like us to change things around.
Which is normal. When you've got an idea, you like it to come through and see it on the ice the way you see it, not the way anybody else sees it. Mm-hmm. It takes a while before it sinks in and you finally understand. You think you understand, and then once you've thought about it and he explains it to you again, you get deeper into the subject and you find out what exactly he wants. And then it's easier to work on the things knowing what you're doing and why you're doing it, what you're trying to portray.
Say they watch various programs, oh, that's Christopher Dean. I don't see it as a style. People may identify it because it looks different, but there isn't a movement or a position or a way of carriage that suggests Christopher Dean. It may be just in that, oh, it looks different, that suggests that. And I'm still searching for that style. I don't know where it is. Maybe it will come. But that's what I want, the opportunity to develop that and to do more and more work.
Another collaboration resulting from their tour was with a young Russian couple, Natalia Anenko and Genrik Stratensky. Once again, Dean's choreography is motivated by his own experience in Russia. For this dance, he took as his theme, Falling Idols.
We study people and we study situations, and I believe very much so to experience a situation helps to perform it and say, okay, what is this emotion at this time? What am I thinking? What's the idea in my head? When I talk of sometimes that the ice skaters become so narrow-minded and closeted within the world that they haven't experienced other things sometimes that they're trying to pull off on the ice, that they're trying to recreate. The dance, I mean, the music for me suggests something quite sad, remorseful, and a feeling of sort of apathy as well. It sort of kept going, and it's sort of deeper feeling of sadness and almost a state that you're living in that you can't get out of.
We were trying to say, you know, you could almost relate it to a life in the Soviet Union, going through a bad period, like with bad weather when there's no food, etc., etc., and the only way out is, like, he decides the best way is to kill his wife or his lover or whatever, so that it's better than actually living. That was the sort of end solution that you said. And I tried to get these little stories over.
Well, the fact that there was, you know, no hope left.
No hope in the end.
And that was the final solution. But I don't know whether they actually understood that, what we were trying to get that total feeling out. I think... maybe they didn't, and I don't know whether at that time when we were choreographing it, whether we were that specific about it as well, because it, you know, it's a delicate area, of course, you know.
Yeah.
we didn't want to be specific, but if we started saying, well, this is, you know, it's like Russia, that
well, they know it's hard. I mean, they always say it's hard when they go home, there's no food, etc., life's harder.
Was just about completed by the time the show had run to its end, and they went away to Russia, and we didn't see it again until 3 months later.
About 3 months later, with the competition itself,
of which we were competing against them.
Yes.
Which was unusual, sort of
funny situation.
Working against somebody that you've been working with, but we didn't really view it as that. You know,
no.
It's an opportunity to choreograph on other people. And for that to be seen, and also for ourselves to go, and the fact that this was an avenue, the competition, but it was an avenue that we could go down and perform and show something new again.